Without you, I fall apart.
is found is where you are.
And I
This is my day.
Every word spoken. The more I sweet anchovy. Drink from the cup in your hand. Lay back against you and breathe. Feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep. It's more than I can stand. I'm melt in your hands. It's overwhelming.
Should the blood of Christ, though, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God to purge our conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Purging our conscience to serve. It goes on the next chapter, it says, and every priest stands ministering daily. You can serve. And offering repeatedly the same sacrifices, which can never really take away sins. But this man, after he offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God. And from that time he's waiting till his enemies are made his footstool. For by one offering he perfected forever those who are being sanctified. Our conscience is constantly being purged through the sanctification that comes by the word. And since the Holy Spirit witnesses to us of this fact, for with the covenant that we have received has put laws, his truth in our hearts, and our minds will be rewritten by those laws in our hearts. And their sins and their lawless deeds I'll remember no more. Where there's remission of these, there's no longer an offering for sin. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by that overwhelming love, by a new and living way which he consecrated for us through the veil, that is the flesh, having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience, our bodies washed with pure water. Let us then hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And here's the next one. And let us consider the assembly of ourselves together. Let us not forsake it, as will be the matter of some in the last days that we're in now. But we should exhort one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. So much more as you see the day approaching. You know, the overwhelming love God gave to us through his Son should cause in our hearts not only be purged of our conscience, which brings us a new life and a new purpose, but it also should cause us to want to serve one another. want to stir up love and good works. What are the good works? The good works are witnessing to others. The good works are serving in the church to minister to others. The good works are walking in the promises of God to receive His healing and prosperity. There's so many good works that come by us remembering that love that we've received, that overwhelming love. Now, if you remember someone's love, we had Memorial Day last week, remembering the highest sacrifice of love, which would be giving your life for others. Remembering those that loved you, you don't forget them. Remember their love. And remembering the love of Christ should motivate us to assemble, to praise, to worship, to grow, to reach out, to ever walk in the love that God's given us, we give to others. And therefore we forsake not what is the goodness of God, of coming together and worshiping together, reaching out to others, especially in the days that we are in. So take this in remembrance. God's given us a promise and a future. That we stir up love and good works by remembering we've been purged of our conscience, purged of the sins that we have by the once and final sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. That we have been redeemed. And we have boldness to enter the holy place for all and any situation we're in and for the needs of others. Remember. Body was broken for us. We now give thanks for the cleansing that purges our conscience from all sin. That our forgiveness is not by our own works, but our forgiveness is by the work of Christ. And therefore we follow in the works of Christ, that we too stir up love as He did. We too do the good works of God as He did. We too stand purged of a conscience, forgiven and rejoicing and bringing forth the good news to others. Bring forth the good news to each other as we stir up that love and that good works among one another, as well to others outside this church. We give you the thanks and the praise for the sanctification that came by the blood of Jesus to cleanse our hearts, to write your new laws upon our hearts and upon our minds, that we might live free, forgiven, redeemed, delivered, prosperous, and in health. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we have such good news, such good promises, such truth. Let it not just come by word, but let it be in our hearts and may it change our minds. That we walk in redemption. We walk with joy on our face, happiness in our hearts, witnessing to others of the love of God. For that is the purpose we're called to do. Stir up love and good works. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Well, at this time, if you would do so, receive your offerings. There are envelopes at the back of the chair, so take one of those and fill that out if you haven't done that already. And while you're doing that, we want to also remind you, this is going to be Get Acquainted Sunday. Sometimes people don't get to know everybody as they would like, so this is the first Sunday of each month. It's going to be Get Acquainted, wear a name tag, take some time after service to have fellowship with one another. This is also a day we decided a good way to have fellowship is to eat something, right? This is a church, right? So we're having cake today to celebrate anybody having a birthday, right, Don? So my wife put this together. It looks like, so far, here's who we know has a birthday in June. Dee, we have an anniversary. How can they have an anniversary in June when they just got married in May? I don't understand. It's May. Is it May 6th they just got married?
Yeah.
But you know, you can celebrate your anniversary again. Just do it every month.
1 month anniversary.
1 month anniversary. That's what she's trying to say. I get it now.
It's a,
no, it's okay. It's okay. They're newlyweds. Let them celebrate the
month.
Today we're celebrating 1 month Paul and Megan being married. Hallelujah. Okay. Now, Jeff and Ellie already left to go up to North Carolina for a few months, so that's their birthday they'll have in the hills of the Carolinas. The 27th, Char is a year younger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's right. No, that's the way it works. You're you want to keep up when you're little, but then you sort of get that mid-range you don't want to know. But then when you get older, this is great. It's another year of rejoicing. Amen.
Go there.
Yeah. Amen. So, looks like we have one birthday to sing to then, right? Sharks. So you ready? Count to one, a two, a three, just like Lawrence Welk. I didn't have any bubbles. Ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sean. Happy birthday to you.
Hey! Now, you gotta stay and eat cake, because Shark can't take the whole half cake.
Oh, no.
What half she do? On the home, so you gotta help us. So be sure and stay after service and have fellowship and some cake as we celebrate Shark's birthday.
Amen. There you go.
So let's ask the Lord's blessing on our giving today. Father, we're indeed thankful for the opportunity to give unto you. We're thankful for the help that we've been able to receive each month to give unto our missionaries, Rowan Sharp, and we also give unto FCM and Metropolitan Ministries. And we just thank you for those outreaches we are a part of every month. And we thank you for this special day to learn and understand how to pray for Rowan Sharp as they go forth in their ministry. May you bless this time, bless their ministry, and may you bless all those today that are giving and giving generously to the work of God. In Jesus' name, the saints say, amen. You may serve the people. Wednesday night, we're continuing on the miracles of Jesus in the book of John. So if you haven't been out, come out and join us at 7 o'clock. And we're learning a number of things on miracles and keeping our faith built up. So I encourage you to come out for that Wednesday night at 7. Amen. Today, as I said, we're going to give Roy and Char the service today because Roy has a number of things to share about what's happening with the missions in Russia, and we've always been